Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be talking about all the witchy books because it's the month of October and I love reading witchy books in this month. Also, if you like to read other genres in this month, then you should check my fall book recommendations video. I have talked about all the different genres. Now, let's get started. So the first book I'm going to be talking about is Letter to Three Witches. Our main character Gwen's grandfather did some magic and it had catastrophic effects. So their entire bloodline was banned from doing magic from the coven, and there are some spies who actually keep an eye on them to check ke wo actually magic karte hai ya nahin karte hai. And one day Gwen's cousins get a letter from her stepsister Tanith, and she has said that she has bewitched one of their partners and she is going to run away with them by the end of the week. So ab sare jo cousins hai, they are all like scared ke whose partner is going to be, like they start doubting their partners ke like actually मेरा पार्टनर हो सकता है या किसी और का. सो दैट्स द होल थिंग. सो दे आर ऑल स्ट्रेस्ड एंड वन ऑफ हर कजिन्स इज अ बेकर. शी एक्सीडेंटली पुट्स मैजिक इन द बेकिंग एंड द एंटायर टाउन इज नाउ सफरिंग फ्रॉम द साइड इफेक्ट्स. ऑल्सो देर इज अनदर थिंग विच शी स्ट्रेसफुली डज एंड नाउ ग्वेनेथ एंड हर कजिन्स आर ट्राइंग टू फिगर आउट के ये वाला इशू कैसे सॉल्व करें एंड दे आर डूइंग ऑल द थिंग्स टू फिगर आउट एवरी थिंग बाय द एंड ऑफ द वीक. देर इज अ कपकेक शॉप, देर इज magic, there are potions, there's like the entire witchy setup. So it's very magical, it's very cozy and it gives fall vibes, and I love that book. It's a 5 stars from me and it gives fall vibes. It's a 5-star book for me and you should read it too. So the next two books are part of a duology called Hex, and the first book is Go Hex Yourself and second is What the Hex. Very funny. There are witches and there are warlocks and there are familiars. The witches and warlocks need magic, and if they want to do big magic, they need big power, big energy, and for that they use familiars and they use their energy and their powers and do the magic. So that's how the magic works in this book. So the main character in the first book thinks that she is applying for a job, like which is like named after spells, but she didn't think that it's actually a magical job. And she realizes that she can see and feel magic because she has that spark. And she is a familiar now for a very old and powerful witch. And the witch is nice. She is eccentric. She is weird. But she is nice. She is not that bad. Her nephew is very rude and mean. It's kind of enemies, haters to lovers kind of a trope. Because they hate each other first. And then they actually get to know each other. Because something happens and they are trying to figure out that. There's always some sort of mystery in all these witchy books. Not necessarily a murder mystery, but something like something is going on. They are trying to figure out. They are trying to solve things. So that's what is happening in this book as well. So that's how they get together, get to know each other. In the second book, the female character already knows that she is a familiar, but she hasn't been picked to be somebody, some witch's familiar. And this warlock is banished because he does some dangerous spells, so he's banished, but he needs a familiar, and so they decide to have a deal that she can be his familiar, but they have to pretend that they are fake dating. It's Grumpy Ex Sunshine plus fake dating. The world is same. The characters are fun in both the books. The books are nice. They are fun to listen to. Like I listened most of these books on audiobook. So yes, definitely read these books. The next series is a full blown series. Like there are 4 books in this series as of now. I don't know if there are new books coming out, but ये चार तो है पक्का. It's called Fix It Witches. During the first book, the writing was okay. I'm not gonna lie, it bored me a little. But as the series progressed, the writing got better, the plot was better. And third and fourth books are my personal favorite, especially the last book, The Only Purple House in the Town. It's so similar to House in the Cerulean Sea. Like it constantly reminded me of that book. So if you like that book and if you like the magical aspect of that book, then you should read it. And it's not that heavily connected to the other 3 books. बाकी के 3 कैसे है कि like they are friends, they are part of a coven and हम एक एक की story देखते हैं. But last book is like it's set in the same town but they barely meet the coven. ऐसा है. So you can read it independently. You don't have to read the entire series. Even the third book was really good. Like out of all the books, third was my second favorite. Again, very witchy, very rom-com-y vibes. I liked it. If you like plot more than characters, then you should read Small Town Big Magic. There's again a small town, there's magic happening. It gives like those, not like the cozy witchy vibes, but the witchy witchy vibes. There's a bookshop, there's a huge house, there's magic, there are multiple creatures. It's very dark compared to all the other books. Like इवन द अर्लियर सीरीज विच आई टॉक्ड अबाउट, उससे भी ज़्यादा ही, मतलब वो सारी थोड़े लाइट बुक्स है, बट दिस इट हैज़ वेरी डार्क वाइब. बट द मेन कैरेक्टर वॉज नॉट माई फेवरेट. सो इफ यू प्रेफर प्लॉट ओवर कैरेक्टर्स देन यू शुड रीड दिस बुक, अदरवाइज स्किप इट. आई थिंक यू मस्ट हैव ऑलरेडी हर्ड अबाउट द नेक्स्ट सीरीज आई एम गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट. इट्स कॉल्ड The XX, The Kiss Curse. You know there are rom-coms which are very light, some are very heavy. These come in the lightest part of the spectrum because they are so simple, they are very cozy. They are like, you, if you want to watch a simple Hallmark movie with witches and the magic and the atmosphere, then you should read these books. There are some sort of like dark elements to it, like not dark, but there are some magic, witchy magic happening. Shops names are like very punny, the everything is very very witchy, very magical, and I love to read that those books. They are very light, I can listen to them while doing some chores, so I love that series, definitely check it out. The next book is called Hex Appeal, and the main character lives in this mansion which is always changing. There's magic in that mansion, like very Encanto vibes, and there are multiple witches living in that house. They all have very different abilities, they have very different magic, and one day a guy comes to this town who is a descendant of a person who lent the house to the witches' family. So basically he is their landlord and they have never paid rent since 1800, so the rent is huge and she doesn't know ke wo kaise usko pay karegi. But also things start happening and they are pulled in all the magical stuff. This was the only book which had very complex system of magic. There are things happening, there is a small time travel into it. You have to be present in the book, like you have to know ke kya chal raha hai to figure out and understand what is going on, ke aise hi side mein sunte sunte nahi hota hai. But yes, it's interesting if you like to read, like अगर आपको light नहीं थोड़े interesting वाले magic चाहिए then you should read this book. Talking about a book which I recently read, like in the last month I read this book and it's called Hot Ex-Boyfriend. Delia Meriwether's family has always said that they are a family of witches but they don't have magic. But they say that they are hex, so that's why they don't have magic. And she thinks it's just a tale, but it's not the case. They are actually witches and they are actually hexed, and who hexed them is their neighbor's great great grandfather. And the grandpa who was living in that house recently passes away, and his grandson comes to the town to manage the estate, but that's not the case. He's also there to keep an eye on Delia because she's actually a witch, blue witch, and only she can break the curse, and that too before her 30th birthday. And her 30th birthday is a week away, so he's there to keep an eye on her. So we see if the curse gets broken, how it gets broken, because that's the biggest mystery. Of course we all know ke wo break hoga hi, but we see ke wo kaise hota hai, that's the biggest mystery. We are also seeing what is happening in their magical society. There are witches, they are all distinguished, like there are brain witches, there are heart witches. So we see all how all the witches are treated, what they can do with their magic, what is happening in their town, in their magical society, and there's a Halloween festival. So it's very magical, it's very witchy, it gives those Halloween vibes. There's a familiar, an imp familiar, I don't know what are imps, but there's an imp familiar whose name is Nikki, and he takes the form of a cat. So he's cute, he is always there meddling, doing things. He is the catalyst of that book. So yes, I loved the book. It was very fun, very magical. The next book is a cozy mystery with witches and magic, and it's called Something Wicked. Our main character's aunt passes away and she leaves her entire mansion and her shop to her. She comes to the town and she wants to start a new life, and the tea shop is magical because they are actually witches, so the teas are magical, and that tea shop also has a part bookshop. So it's like the perfect combination ke log aate hain, books padhte hain, tea lete hain, some scones, some baked goods lete hain, they just sit there, they read. My mother sneezed, I don't know if you heard her or not, but that happened. So it's very magical, and then a murder happens, and of course she's our main character, so she has to solve the murder. Also there's a detective who was her childhood friend, so we see something going on between those two. It's very cute, it has that small town vibe, and it's very small town, like this, the town is literally small. There are like ek ek karke char shops hai wahan pe. Everything is magical, everything is enchanted. Not enchanted, like it feels cozy. They don't have magic actually, sirf ye tea shop mein hi hai, but it's good, it's nice. I am excited to read the next book. Then I also read some other witchy books. They were very average for me, but you might like them, so I'm going to pop the covers here so that if you want, if the cover intrigues you, if their blurb intrigues you, then you can pick them. There's one bonus recommendation, and it's not book related, it's a TV show. It's called Good Witch. If you like Gilmore Girls, those vibe, those cozy town, the fall, everything like that, but if you want to see more magic, then you should watch this show. There's a B&B, there's a magical shop, there's a cafe, the town they always celebrate fall and Halloween. And even though the show's name is Good Witch, it's not mentioned that they are witches. So it's like the magic is very vague. They get intuitions, they can feel other person's energy. So it's like that. There are some town secrets, so we get to see those as well. Like there are some gems, there are some sort of mystery which they are solving, like not in all the episodes but in some episodes. If you like that magical cozy vibe, then you should definitely watch Good Witch. And yes, that's it for today's video. Those are all my recommendations, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and thanks for watching. Bye.